this wonderful occasion, I would like to introduce you tonight, Honorable Cosmin Dumitrescu, Consul General of Romania in Los Angeles.
Ladies and gentlemen, Angela Stewart, Daniela Podobea, and the pianist, Daniel Manoiu. Please give it. A wonderful night with wonderful people. Before beginning my diplomatic speech, I would like to invite here on the stage with me the representatives of the Department of State, the director, Cristina Hernandez, and the head of protocol of LA County, our dear friend, Lourdes Khan. Please join me.
Good evening. It's such a pleasure to be here tonight representing U.S. federal government and also sharing your special night with the Romanian community here in Los Angeles. And what a vibrant and beautiful community it is. My personal experience with Romania is very limited. I was kind of in the neighborhood when I was stationed in Budapest. I know that some of those borders have overlapped over the years, but I did get an opportunity to meet a lot of wonderful Romanian folks through my work in the region, and I'm so proud to be here tonight and honored, actually. As you know, our countries have a very strong bilateral relationship. We've had diplomatic ties since 1880 and have continued on and off, mainly on, in recent years with Romania and helping also to support their nomination into NATO and other multilateral organizations. We're very proud to have Romania as a partner. Our embassy there and your embassy here, together we work to help fight transnational crime, corruption, improve security, prosperity, and the fun stuff, which is the cultural exchanges and opportunities like tonight. So again, very honored to be here with you tonight, and congratulations on 100 years, Romania.
Good evening, Bună seara, Consul General Cosmin Dumitrescu, Mirela, beautiful spouse, I haven't seen her yet, Dumitrescu. Wonderful community that is part of what makes our county very, very strong. It is the diversity, it is the, I'm sorry to say, the brain drain that we give you because you're all here. Thank you for enriching the county. I'm here on behalf of the five members of the Board of Supervisors of the County of Los Angeles. I know most of you are from LA County. I know some of you have come from Vegas and Orange County. So it speaks to the importance of the work that you do, Consul General. Very dynamic. It's hard to keep up with his schedule. We see him everywhere, so you are being well represented. So I'm very honored because I have a wonderful plate of food that is absolutely delicious. So I'm going to just go to the point and present to you this scroll in commemoration of the 100th and many, many more centuries of prosperity, friendship with our region, celebrating Romania. It is signed by the five members, Board of Supervisors, Sheila Kuhl, Hilda Solis, Mark Willie Thomas, Janice Hahn, and Catherine Barger.
Much. I'm so honored that I'm taking this recognition on behalf of Romania, on behalf of our extraordinary Romanian-American community here, not only in Los Angeles County, but everywhere in the United States of America. Thank you so much. So I'm taking the water because I'm going to talk. By the way, that's a Romanian water directly from the Carpathian Mountains. Pure, the best one. and of course a sponsor. So, Honorable Consul General, members of the Consul, of course, represented in Los Angeles, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, dear members of the Romanian American communities, today I am privileged to be here in front of so many friends of Romania for celebrating together one of very important moments of the Romanian history, the centennial of the Great Union Day of Romania, the National Day of Romania, and of all Romanians. I'd like to start by thanking each and every one of you for accepting our invitation and by extending my gratitude to our sponsors that made possible this evening. And I'm only to call them by their name. Mr. Tanklos and the Quanta Kinetic Holdings, Mrs. Simona and Adrian Bot, dear friends, fantastic Romanians. One of them is a genius, I can say. Mr. Victor Tolan and BK Precision Holdings, Mr. Dan Talcoș, Apa Carpatica, and of course, Mrs. Mara Kindrish and Juliana Astaliș. I would like to mention here my amazing team of the Consul General of Romania, the head of the Consular Section, Mrs. Daniela Dumitrescu, the Consul Cristina Petrescu, the Trade Commissioner, Mrs. Simona Steliu, that you already met, see that on the stage, and my amazing assistants, Angela Andronescu and Cristina Petrescu. They worked a lot for this event. I would like to thank them from my heart. They did a lot, of course. Dear friends, Romania celebrates on December 1st, 2018, 100 years from the Great Union Day. Romanian people celebrate with it with gratitude and for the sacrifices of our forefathers who fought for an independent and united Romania. But Romania is not only about 100 years of unity. Allow me to give you some figures about Romania. 5,300 before Christ, the year when the three tablets of Tartaria in Romania have been written attesting the presence of the Romanian ancestors on the territory of the present Romania. 1,300 years old is the Romanian language, spoken continuously by the Romanian people in the region of Danube, Carpathian Mountains and Black Sea. A Latin origin language in the region, completed by several hundreds of words from the ancient people of the ancient Dacia. 159 years since the establishment of Romania, with the name of Romania, after the union between the Romania, Moldova and Wallachia. 141 years since the conquest of the national independence after winning the war against the Ottoman Empire in 1877. 100 years from the Great Union Day, December 1st, 1918. 100 years as a United Nation. 29 years since Romania demolished the terrible communist regime and won the fight for liberty and freedom. 1997 is the year when Romania and the United States of America became strategic partners. 2003 is the year when Romania became a member of NATO. Romania is now the third military contributor in Afghanistan. 2% of the GDP is that what Romania allocated for the defense expenses being between the very few in NATO that fulfills that condition of the treaty. 2007 is the year when Romania became a member state of the European Union. 20 million people are living in Romania. More than 4 million Romanians are living abroad, mainly in the European Union. 6.9% is the economic growth in 2017, 6.1% economic growth in 2018, and a stable forecast for the Romanian economic growth, 5.7% in 2019, and in 2020. These are figures about the real Romania that everybody should know. It's not only about 100 years of United Romania. Ladies and gentlemen, The contribution of the Romanian people to the progress of the humankind is tremendous. From the very many, I will mention now only a few of them. The Romanian physician Victor Babes is well known for his principle of passive immunization and the vaccine for cholera. Aurel Vlaicu, a Romanian engineer and aviator, flew his first airplane in 1910. Traian Vuia invented the first flying machine with its own takeoff systems, propulsion units, and landing gear. Henry Coandă is a Romanian inventor, engineer, and aircraft builder, registered over 250 patents, among which we can find the Coandă effect, practically the birth of the fluid mechanics and the father of the jet propulsion of the planes. Everybody is now using his engines. Petrache Poenaru is the inventor of the fountain pen. Yes, dear friends, the fountain pen was not invented by Mont Blanc. At the time, Mont Blanc was only a mountain between France and Italy. I don't know how many know that, but now everybody knows the pen. No, Petrache Poenaru was the inventor of the fountain pen. Gheorghe Cartean is the Romanian engineer that invented the emission reception device for radio telex bilateral communications. We don't use any more telex. But Cartean was behind it. Gogo Constantinescu collected over 120 patents for sonic rotary engines, sonic perforators, sonic hammers, and other applications of the sonic principles on which was based the device that allowed the airplane-mounted gun to shoot between the blades of the propellers. We don't have engines with the propellers on our military aircrafts, but at the time it was very important for winning wars or for depending countries. Constantin Niculescu invented the calorimeter. Angel Salini built in 1895 over the Danube the longest bridge in Europe and the third in the world, 4,088 meters. It's still on, it's still functional. Good work. Anna Slan is the most praised woman in the world for her contribution in the development of geriatrics and gerontology. Everybody knows the dreams of the Anna Slan. Eliza Leonida Zamfirescu was the first woman to receive an engineering degree in the world. Anastase Dragomir is the Romanian engineer that invented the catapultable cockpit patent, the parent of the pilot ejection seat of today, saving lives of thousands of military pilots. These are only a few of the Romanian inventors that influenced the mankind with their work. We still do have such Romanians. We do have one of our guests here, Adrian Bo, that was praised for his work in treating cancer. If I'm not wrong, it's the first genomic treatment of Hodgkin's syndrome. I'm not a specialist, I'm not going to dive in it. So, this is Romania, dear friends, and the Romanians. And ladies and gentlemen, going down to business about 100 years from the World War I. World War I was a turning point in the history of the world, causing profound global changes and giving a historic lesson that sometimes some people do not manage to learn. The participation of Romania in the World War I is synonymous in the collective memory of the Romanian people with the struggle to achieve the ideal of the United Nations State. This ideal became a reality through the enormous sacrifice assumed by the entire nation, and 1918 embodied the very peak of a national coagulation process crowned by the common will and action of the Romanians living in all the Romanian provinces for the unification with the fatherland. 100 years after the Great Union, Romania is a historically major state with solid economic and cultural ties with all its neighbors, a consistent and credible partner, and a member state within NATO and the EU, actively involved in strengthening the European and the transatlantic projects with a dynamic and a stable economy, ensuring high standards of involvement of national minorities in political and cultural life. Romania is an anchor of stability in Eastern Europe, as well as a very active actor involved in international relations at a global level. And we all see these days how important could be an anchor of stability in Eastern Europe at the Black Sea when we are reading the news about what happens there. Dear friends, the excellent training of Romanian specialists and the very strong Romanian diaspora contribute to global development in top fields and demonstrate the positive impact of Romanians and of my country on the progress of science, technology, education, culture, and art. The cohesion of the Romanian communities living in the diaspora, living abroad, more than 150,000 of which living on the west coast of the United States, is based on the Romanian identity and values, and it is a living proof of the fulfillment of the ideal of unity expressed by the historical act of the 1919, ideally adapted to the new circumstances of the global realities. The Romanian Great Union Day reminds us year after year that we, the Romanians, are a nation, one nation, having the force to fulfill our great ideals regardless of the adversity of the historical circumstances. In the 29 years since the liberation from the communist regime, Romania quickly but seriously crossed the period and the difficulties of a tough translation to democratic consolidation and proved that its place is between the Western states with which Romania shares common values. Romania is today a respected democracy in Europe and in the entire world. My country is a serious and reliable partner within the European Union, in NATO. The strategic partnership with the United States of America is a basic pillar for foreign relations and democracy in Romania. Romanian soldiers and the American soldiers fight together in many operation theaters, Afghanistan, Iraq, and very often they give their life for defending freedom. I always repeat myself that freedom does not come for free. Very often the price is paid, and even when I'm speaking, the price is paid with the blood and life of our military who continue to fight for our nations and for the rights earned with great sacrifices in history. I stop here only for informing you that over there there is an exhibition of photos of pictures taken by the correspondent of war of Radio Romania in Afghanistan, showing many Romanian soldiers fighting there. Some of them lost their life there, and they are pictured. And I know that they are pictured together with American soldiers also. And I am inviting you to see it when you got the time tonight, this evening. So in the international context of asymmetric threats and vulnerability to multidimensional risks, Centennial Romania emerges as a promoter of a long-term peace, justice and development, as demonstrated by the role of human rights defender, the rule of law, the values of democracy, multilateralism, and the understanding among people, both at the international and regional level. Distinguished guests, tolerance, openness, respect for diversity and values are established in Romania and are true catalysts of the Romanian nation, inside and outside the border, thus building a strong country. The Romanian unitary state has made considerable efforts to mitigate or eliminate conflict and revenge mentalities, offering an example of tolerance and respect, values that promotes consistently today in its foreign policy as well. Openness for multiculturalism and cultural diversity, individual and collective tolerance, and implicitly good coexistence and mutual respect within the Romanian society in the spirit of the consistency, continuing and balance are traditional values in Romania already. Democracy in Romania is based on respect for the law and towards the work institutions and traditions, the support of the Romanian school and the support of education of our people. Ladies and gentlemen, Romania is taking the presidency of the Council of the European Union in the first half of the 2019, a time for major transformations for the future of the European Union. the completion of the Brexit process, the preparation of the new multi-annual financial frameworks, the end of the mandate of the European Parliament and of the European Commission, and Romania will prove once again its attachment to the core and the values of democracy and progress. God bless the United States of America. God bless the independent and united Romania. May we all have peace. Thank you very much.